Hello everyone. In next few videos, we will cover AEM as headless concept. In this video, I'm just going to cover what is headless. I mean, what do we mean by headless? Just consider this whole web application as a person, where we have front end as a head, back end data, APIs, etc. And then combining all these data, we form a full website. When we are saying headless, means within AEM, now this head is gone. Head is front end, so front end is gone. So then, but we still need front end, right? We still need some view so that end users can see that data, see this your website, your application, or anything it is. Now it means some other technology is going to take that place. I mean another's head, and AEM still will be there, but as a backend repository. We will expose some APIs through which we will send this data to this another's head. Another's head is going to use to maybe it'll create some view, etc., to show this to the end user. Now to fetch this data from AEM repository, we have various available options. For example, we can have Sling Model Exporter, Content Fragment using GraphQL API and asset APIs. But in next few videos, we are just going to cover content fragments using GraphQL API. And of course, we have advantages. We have fast content delivery. There are various multiple channels. We can utilize the same API. So API is nothing but you have the URL, like we have the REST-based URL. But in this case, we are going to use GraphQL API. So you will have the URL and we will get the data. Easy integration, yeah. And for various technologies, for example, my application is on basis of React technology or maybe Angular technology, or maybe I just want to use a non-native mobile application where I want to get this data, and based on my preference, I want to present it to end user. Let's see, stay connected. We'll see how do we use this AEM as headless concept within AEM. Thank you so much for watching.